Oh, Tony Beckett drops him! Oh, the big kibosh!
As he
here comes Bellingham!
Oh, left hand! Oh, he dropped it!
Punches down on top.
This is awesome! This is crazy!
And it is all over!
This is one that Filipinos have been waiting for. The unleashing of a new superstar at one championship.
Team Lakai's new generation of stars are ready to go for gold. The gym from Baguio City, Philippines, has produced five world champions, and that looks set to continue with its current crop of young lions. Joshua Pascio's talent was plain to see in his first pro fights on the Filipino circuit as a teenager. By the time he was 20, the passion was making waves on the global stage, and it wasn't long before he reached the top. Pascio was just 22 when he won the one strawweight world title for the first time. Fast forward 3 years, and he's the most dominant world champion in the division's history.
Touch gloves and back up.
This is some of the best condition I've ever seen him in. He's going forward. Nice little left high kick landed there by Pascial. He needs to respect the power. Shuko's got to be careful getting that close to him without putting something behind it. You can see him inching forward. See, just like that. Got to be careful.
Nicely placed from Pascial. That knockout of Cerruccia in 2009. Oh, the left hand! Stuns him in another one! And a third, and a fourth, a fifth, a sixth, it's over! Pascio does it again! The champ retains! Absolute inspiration, 25 years old.
Pascio capitalized on that opening, punctuated the trilogy matchup.
Another young lion who has already emerged as an elite contender is flyweight star Danny Kingyad. At only 26, the King has already been one of the division's elite competitors for years. Kingyad enters the circle, never aiming to play it safe.
He's a crafty veteran, big leg kick from the King, and a jumping knee, and Ikeda calls him forward again. Overhook on the arm there momentarily from Ikeda. Kingyad has him on the ground now. What can the King do to keep him there? Takes the back.
He doesn't need the second one. He might transition into mount here. Ikeda's now defending him with the arm. He scrambles, but Kingyad is able to out-scramble him.
Kingyad is up in top position here. Side control for the King. Cuts in the hips. Oh, left hand from Ikeda, and a driving takedown. Sensational so far, the King.
Both itching for a knockout. It's like I'm holding my breath, waiting for it.
Back to their feet, not for long though. Ooh,
beautiful takedown and reversal back to Kingyad. And he still is unaffected, still blitzing forward. He's trying to scramble out of this.
Slower start to the third round for both these men. Jab to Ikeda, uppercut from Kingyad, and the knee. Tried to pull the head down for the meet and greet.
But he's, look how he's got those feet locked. Good job by Kingyad to shake him off. It looks like he's going for a Kimura trap here. Kenzo Ikeda might be able to, because of the position of his arm, he might be able to pull his arm out. Kingyad's preventing the arm from coming over to lock in the choke, but Ikeda gets it in the last minute.
There are many other rising stars at Team Lakai, and two of them will join Kingyad as part of a stacked card at One Winter Warriors 2. Before the King faces Khairat Akhmatov in the main event, 19-year-old John Lo Mark Sangal, son of Team Lakai's head coach Mark Sangal, steps up against Paul Lumihi. And Stephen Lohman makes his long-awaited one debut against Yusup Sadilayev in a bout that could determine the next challenger for the one bantamweight world title.